Hello, my name is Małgosia Minta, and the shortest way to describe it, that's I'm a girl, I'm a geek, and I'm a foodie. And professionally, I work as a journalist, and I write about new technology and how do they affect our daily life and our lifestyle. So today, I would like to talk to you about why we need pink computers. Really, you need pink computers, believe me. So I would start with a question: with whom have you spent your last night? Well, I spent my night with Mac, in effect with MacBook Pro, probably with my iPhone. Under the pillow was e-reader, and there was an iPad as well. And I guess that if you are inviting someone or something to your bed, it must be nice, don't you think? So, a long time ago, but in this galaxy, computers were rather terrible. They were gray, beige, and the best place to put them was under your table. And then, in 98, something happened. It was the iMac G3, and it was, though now it's an icon of, the design, for Apple it was a big risk to put it on the market. It was round, it was transparent, turquoise, something totally different. It was created by this guy. His name is Jonathan Ive, and he is a designer for Apple, and he's creating, well, all of the products of the Apple we know, and we know for them designs. So now we can start to think how we can make gadgets more nice, better looking, more appealing, more funny, more, well, nicer to use, to have them around us. So the simplest way is to add some color, and probably if you are going now to buy any laptop or smartphone, you will have a few color versions to pick from. The second way is to add some shape, some texture to make the product more interesting. My favorite here is the HTC Diamond, which is like a, well, like a jewel, you know, girls like diamonds. The other thing you can do is to add just, well, something. For example, the name of a celebrity or in fashion designer, like with the Lady Gaga's headphones or the Vivienne Tam laptops. It will also be something different. The next thing you can do with your gadget is to make it surprise. That what you are seeing is the Nokia 7380, and it was one of the mobile phones from the L'Amour series. And when I took it to my office and showed them to the people, nobody knew what it was. The other thing, it's that. It's a Bluetooth headset, a totally different thing. Rather nice, it looked like a stone, and in fact, the name of it, it's stone. So, instead of carrying black bag and silver laptops, currently when gadgets are closer to us and they're becoming our, well, everyday item, we want to make them more personal, more special, and that's why we want to customize them. We are adding some jello skins or some covers to make it different, to show that it's ours. Also, quite nice thing is to put an engravement, like, Mom, you rule, and you really rule. So that's why we are making those gadgets more our, more appealing. We are feeling better about them. In TED conference a few years ago, an anthropologist called Don Norman said that his new me is beauty. And before he was thinking that a good thing is a useful thing. And then he started to think that it must be also good looking, that if something looks nicer, it's better working. So he started to think about it, why it's like that. And he came up with the idea that there are three aspects of why nice things are, well, nicer to us. The first thing is that they are visceral, we are feeling in our guts that this is nice. That's why we are buying a water in a nice bottle, not because of the water, but because of the bottle. And here are the three items to remember about the gadgets: that first, they must have good performance, they must be intuitive, and they must be good looking. So thank you very much. Have a nice evening and have some nice gadgets in your pockets.